All right, so I'm 2 weeks post-op rotator cuff surgery. Man, we got a lot to talk about. I'm gonna give you a great update here. I'm gonna tell you what you can expect, how you expect to feel, how your body's gonna react. We're gonna talk about sleeping. We're gonna talk about activities. And the main thing, we're gonna get you back into the gym. That's right, back in the gym. Right now, while you're recovering. Because gentlemen, the name of the game is to not lose any more muscle mass than we already are going through this process. So if you're ready, let's get into this video. What's going on, ladies and gentlemen, for all who are watching this video? Because let's face it, it's not just guys out there that get rotator cuff surgery. So for any of the ladies who have searched and found this video, thank you for watching. Absorb the information. So 2 weeks post-op, I'm feeling really good. I actually gotta watch myself because I could tend to do too much. As you start feeling better, you're gonna be moving this hand. You're gonna be grabbing stuff. You can't help it. It's natural. You just got to catch yourself and put things down. You know, I'm washing dishes with two hands. You know, I'm keeping the pressure off, but trust me, you got to watch it because you do get comfortable with it. So things I'm doing different between this surgery and my previous surgery 5 years ago. I beefed up 10 pounds before the surgery because what happened to me last time is I lost 17 pounds after that surgery, and I'm going to be dipped if that happens again. I lost my muscle mass. I got skinny. I just concentrated on cardio when I went to the gym, and I wasn't lifting. And what happens when you do too much cardio? Well, you suppress your testosterone. You're actually making it worse. So you're depleting your testosterone when you need it most. And that's right now, after surgery, when you have to recover. So what's the remedy? It's to produce testosterone. So get in the gym and start lifting weights. Yes, with your good half, you can do it. I'm gonna show you how to do that in this video. But you have to have strict form and you have to consult with your doctor, okay? Don't listen to me. I'm kinda out there, okay? I'm gonna experiment with a lot of things. But you gotta consult with either your therapist or your doctor to make sure it's all right with you. Okay, so the history of where I'm at on these 2 weeks. I've been off pain meds as of day three after surgery. And ladies and gentlemen, the key to recover is to get off of them pain meds as fast as possible. Now, right now, I am doing Tylenol and Advil. I'm kind of mixing up between the two, and let me give you my opinion on this. Right now, I think that the Tylenol is taking a little bit more of this edge off than the Advil, but I don't like taking Tylenol because it's bad for your liver. Now the key after any surgery is tissue repair. What are you doing to help your tissue repair? Nothing? Any vitamins? Anything? Let me suggest something to you, all right? Vitamin C, sodium absorbate. Now this is a powder. You take a half of a level teaspoon, and I mix this with my morning workout drink, which is my amino acids. I have creatine, and I sip this in the gym during my workout. And take my advice on this. If you chug that powdered vitamin C, you're gonna end up in the bathroom, okay? So the key is to sip it. You do it once in the morning and then once at night. You need to do this twice a day. Again, consult with your physician on that. My goal is to stay in the gym, stay on my workout routine, just like I was doing before this surgery. Only I'm working out one half of my body. Now, a lot of people are gonna probably say, you know, you're crazy. The body is not meant to be worked out on one side. Well, I have a different take and a different philosophy on that, okay? And there are some findings that will say that if you do work out the one side of your body, it does fire up some nerves and it does travel. Now, I don't know if there's any truth to that, but I'm going with that. So the more blood I get pumping through my body, in my mind, okay, I'm feeling it's getting up to here. It's getting to this injury. It's getting to this surgically repaired shoulder, and it is sending all them nutrients, vitamins, and blood flow, and vitamin C, and everything into this area because my blood is flowing. If you get this surgery and you just go sit on the couch, okay, good luck with your recovery. All right, now sleeping. Sleeping is the number one evil thing that's gonna happen to you after your surgery. It's virtually impossible because you can't get comfortable. Because when you lay flat, it puts pressure on this shoulder and it's very uncomfortable. It's jarring pain. So you have to sleep upward. You might even sleep on your favorite chair in the living room. Sleep in bed, but prop the pillows up. But I'm gonna show you a great, great sleeping device that my daughter turned me on to, my pregnant daughter, which helps pregnant women get comfortable. And when she first showed me this thing, I go, get this thing out of here. I'm not gonna use this. It's been the greatest thing, and I'm gonna show it to you. All right, so here it is. You see how this, thing works out? You put this on the bed, all right? And your body sits in the middle of this, okay? It opens up and you stack a couple of pillows on that. And the name of the game with this device here is it keeps your whole body level. Not just one side that you prop up with pillows that you're always gonna be rolling off and turning at night. You're never gonna keep those pillows there. But that device keeps you locked in. You could move it, you could enter and exit out of it. It is the absolute best device made for rotator cuff surgery. So for all of you who are wondering, how long does it take the incisions to heal? Well, let me show you. Again, we're 2 weeks post-op. How does it look? Can't even see anything, right? Well, first of all, you know, the tattoos are definitely hiding it. So let me show you the one. Here's the one incision right here. Second one right there. And the third one is right here. All right, and as you can see, they are healing up very, very nice. So after 2 weeks, the wounds are starting to rise. I can feel it healing really good. And that's how my body heals. I actually have a problem. I overheal. It's called keloid, where your body keeps healing and healing and healing. So sometimes I could scar up real bad. So I don't know how this is going to end up for me. But right now, I'm very happy with it. And you never know that I had anything done. All right, let's go to the gym. Let me show you a few exercises that you can do. It has to be done with total strict form. And if you do it that way, you're going to come up with fantastic results and how quick you can heal. So this is the only exercise that I'm allowed to do for the next 6 weeks. This is it, according to my doctor. No one knows how bad a rotator cuff surgery is going to be until they actually get in there. And when my doctor got in there, they were very, very surprised because it was tore completely off the bone. There was a vicious tear. So they want to take precaution with me. All right. So this is it. A lot of you guys are going to get in therapy maybe 2 weeks after, maybe even a week after. All right. But I'm 6 weeks, nothing but this. All right. So let's look at my body. Now, besides the extra weight that I put on, and I'm regretting it now because I am holding my muscle mass and my weight pretty good, but unfortunately, it's right here. So now I'm getting vicious with my diet because now it's time to start leaning out because I feel I've got this under control. I mean, but here's my posture. This is the best that I can do, you know, without the sling. And you can see how the right side of my body, you know what? Yeah, it's hanging down. If you think that you're going to get the shoulders up and back, it's not going to happen. And you don't want to do that. You don't want to put any stress on it. And as you can see, the atrophy has already set in on this side of my body. I'm losing my muscle, you know, in the bicep already. The shoulder, I can actually see I'm losing it in the shoulder too, you know, compared to this one. I'm hoping that this is gonna be it. You just never know, because I'm only 2 weeks into it. I got 6 months to go. So before we end this video, let's talk about something else that's very vital, and that's nutrition. Now, at this time, more than ever, nutrition is going to play a big role in your recovery. So put away the snacks and the garbage, all that crap, and start honing in on your diet. Because let's face it, we are going to be sedentary for a long time. Well, let me just say the average person will. And what's going to happen? You're going to put on a lot of weight, okay? Trust me, because you're not half, not even remotely close to being half, as active as you were before. So what happens? You're going to put on the beef. So unfortunately, I did too. All right, now it's time to clean it up, hone in on these diets, and keep our body in the best possible physical shape. I'm going to show you my post-workout breakfast. This is packed with protein, good carbs, and good fats, and it's very satisfying. Brown rice cake, 1 tablespoon full of almond peanut butter, and 35 grams of protein powder. That's my daily go-to post-workout breakfast. That fuels me, that gives me my protein, that gives me my carbs, that gives me my good fats, all wrapped up in one. And guess what? It tips under 500 calories. All that food, and trust me, I am full all the way up to lunch. Another thing you need to do is you need to consume water. You need to keep flushing your system. You need to keep your body hydrated, especially after surgery. If you get dehydrated, you're gonna set yourself back in this recovery process. So water is very, very important. So I hope this video served you right. The name of the game, people, is to keep moving, keep your body moving, get healthy, and we can do it together. We're gonna hit triceps, we got our legs to do, we got our chest to do, we got our back to do, we got so much to do. But we can do it together. And together, we can heal. Together, we can prosper. Together, we're on the road to recovery. So if you enjoyed this video, if you found it useful, smash that like button. And don't you dare forget to subscribe to this channel. And always remember, gentlemen, and any ladies who are watching, guys over 50, we're not dead. We're just getting started.